I love Kate Middleton. She is such a style icon for many of us around the world. And today I'm going to try some of the items on that she has worn that became truly iconic. And you know what? You're going to be able to buy these items too after this video. So the first item that I want to present to you is the boots, because these boots are a big favorite of Kate Middleton. And actually, she has been wearing them for about 20 years, the same pair. Yes, that's how much she loves it. And a little FYI, I happen to own a pair too. So these boots are from a brand called Penelope Shilvers, and they're called the Standard Tassel Boot. They cost around $700 US, and I'm gonna sell you that because I own a pair. These are such good quality boots. So these boots are from sustainably sourced Spanish leather, and they are hand cut, and they have the scallop detail and this cute little leather tassel to kind of give them its signature. So Kate loves wearing these boots whenever she has an engagement on the countryside or whenever she's doing any outdoorsy activities, both in her personal life or also, of course, in her public life. She likes to pair them often with jeans or other type of outdoorsy clothes, and I think that this is a perfect look for the countryside. I also like wearing them on a Sunday or whenever I go and see my horse at the stable. I must tell you though, because I have worn these boots a lot myself, they're really comfortable. Maybe not so much to go for a hike, but definitely you can walk around these shoes, you can be comfortable, and they're very spacious, especially after they mold to your foot and to your leg. So I can understand why Kate Middleton loves these boots. So next up, we have this pleated Karen Millen Forever Dress. And the Forever Dress is a staple for Karen Millen. They have been having this dress for years and years, and it comes out in different variations. I myself wore it in 2018, a different variation than what you're seeing right now. And I wore it to one of my live TV appearances that I did on British TV. And as you know, Kate Middleton loves supporting British brands, which is why she tends to wear Karen Millen from time to time. So Kate Middleton wore this dress when she visited Surrey County Hospital in October 2022. She did, however, wear it in kind of a mustard yellow type of color, and unfortunately, it was sold out, so I couldn't get my hands on it. But I'm actually not too sad about it, because mustard yellow is one of my no-no colors. It just doesn't go with my skin color and my complexion. Instead, I went for baby blue because it's actually one of my best colors. But do I love this dress? No, I actually am quite surprised that it looks so good on Kate Middleton, because I don't think it looks as good on me. What do you think? I'm finding it to be a little bit on the frumpy side. I think it's elegant, of course, but I find it so conservative that I wonder, where would I ever wear this dress to? I certainly would feel a little bit of a grandma, let's say, if I wore this dress to, I don't know, a ladies' luncheon or something like that. But of course, nature of Kate Middleton's job is that she's always in very conservative and formal occasions, meaning that she does wear these kind of hyper elegant clothes all the time. But I believe that it's important for us to understand that these type of clothing might feel a little bit out of place in certain occasions. So of course, I'm an advocate for an elegant style, but you have to sometimes think about that. An elegant style can also feel easily too elegant and too stuffy, which is something us ladies need to pay attention to. I don't know what to say, because first of all, this is not the exact dress that Kate wore. The dress she wore to Wimbledon in 2021 has shorter sleeves, but technically, everything else is the same. I need to be honest with you, because this is where my issue steps in when it comes to elegant fashion. I am an advocate for elegant fashion, but I don't like when elegance starts to look old-fashioned. I love vintage fashion, but when it becomes a bit too old-fashioned. Do you see the difference? I love elegance when it feels modern. That's why I have used the terminology modern elegance, because I don't really believe in the old stuffy traditional elegance that just takes us back in times and times, even though I like vintage. But I hope you're seeing my point. If I went to Wimbledon like this, I would feel a little bit awkward. The silhouette of the dress feels old-fashioned, okay? It is vintage, let's put it this way, which I don't mind. I wouldn't have minded this dress in another color. And that's where issue number two steps in, because I think this kind of baby pink becomes too much on a dress that already feels too much. Adding also this frill effect of the sleeves, I don't know. I feel like this dress is very dated. The reason to why we couldn't get the original dress that Kate wore is because it was out of stock, so this is the best we could do. And mind you, I think the one in shorter sleeves would have probably worked so much better than the one that I'm wearing. Now, I'm aware, ladies, that many of you on this channel, you might enjoy the kind of prim and proper style of elegance, so I don't want to dismiss that, but I must tell you that that is not at all my style. And for me, this feels a little bit too much kind of prim and proper, little miss elegance in a way. Now, do you know that you can level up your life just the way Kate Middleton did? Oh yes, she did not come from a wealthy background originally. She was just like you and me, but she became successful because she decided to take action and change her life. If that's something you're interested in, then I have prepared a free workshop for you. If you go to fabulousfutureformula.com, you're gonna take part of a workshop where I really break down the leveling up process for you so that you can transform yourself and achieve amazing success just like Kate Middleton did. And you know what? This workshop is free. So just go to fabulousfutureformula.com. It's a brand new workshop that is only here for a limited amount of time. Hurry up and grab it before it's too late. So now I'm wearing this beautiful silk blouse from a brand called Windsor. As you can see, it has a really cute pussy bow. Very classic and elegant style. Now, Kate Middleton, she wore this blouse actually in a blue version. Unfortunately, once again, it was sold out, but I really do like the blue version that she has because it matches so well that the coat she's wearing in this picture with the navy blue pants and shoes. Such a cute look that kind of stands out and looks a little bit different while it's quite elegant in its own way. Now, what I like about this blouse is actually the material. It has a beautiful silk touch and feeling to it, like really high quality silk. This blouse costs around 300 British pounds, which, okay, it is a bit on the premium side for a blouse, but you know what? Is that a blouse like this you can easily find in any store, whether it's the high street, fast fashion, premium, designer, you name it. But what I like about this blouse in particular is the fact that I actually would love to spend a little bit more in order to get this type of quality. Because if you look up close on this blouse, you will see that there is a finesse to it. It looks very high quality, it feels high quality. So when you wear this blouse, you feel high end. So for me, I rather just have one perfect blouse versus six. It's just so much more worth it in the long run. Rather have less, but in higher quality than more of poorer quality. How can I not mention the heels that Kate Middleton always wears? Pretty much everywhere and all the time. Here I have two pumps. They look kind of identical to each other, but these two are frequently worn by Kate Middleton. I'm actually gonna review them both and see which one is better. So first we have this LK Bennett, which is a British brand, a pump costing around $400. And you can see it's in a nice nude color. The heel size of the shoe is about 10 centimeters. And in my opinion, I personally don't like to wear heels that are higher than 10 centimeters because it can easily feel too high and too raunchy. And you know, Royal Protocol is all about not being raunchy, so you will also never really see Kate wearing anything higher than this. So where did we see Kate wear this shoe? Well, we did see her touring around India in 2016, where she was constantly actually wearing this shoe. I was joking and thinking that, you know, maybe it's because she didn't bring another pair on that trip, and that's why she was re-wearing it all the time. Although Kate is actually well known for re-wearing clothes, which is a wonderful thing from a sustainability perspective. And then we have the Jimmy Choo. It's almost double in price. $700 approximately. The heel size is actually what makes it more different from this shoe, because this one is slightly smaller, 8.5 centimeters to be exact, which is actually a heel size that I personally prefer, because it's a heel size that always feels appropriate both for evening and for daytime occasions. It is called Romy, and she has it in 6 different colors. So she has them in nude. She also has this shoe in verdigris, which is kind of a sage color. Then she has them in black suede, she has them in burgundy suede, and then gold glitter and silver glitter. I was actually quite surprised when I noticed that she has them in glitter, because glitter is not really the type of thing you'd expect Kate Middleton to wear. And frankly, when I look at the outfits that she has worn these glitter shoes with, I'm a little bit surprised. So what do you think? Why does Kate love wearing these shoes so much? Well, if you have followed my channel, you will know that I'm a big advocate for having a pair of skin-colored pumps that are very neutral so that you can wear them with any outfit and they're very elongating for the leg. And of course, that is a reason to why Kate is wearing these a lot. But not only that, a pair of pumps are always more conservative than just some random sandals. So of course, for her type of formal occasions, she has to wear a lot of pumps. And these are very neutral. They're also quite comfortable, but they're also very elegant. There is a big price difference, but actually these shoes look quite identical to each other. The differences to the eye, as I can see, is that the color of the LK Bennett shoe compared to the Jimmy shoe is actually better. So this shoe gets my vote versus this one. I think it doesn't really go well with my skin color, but I am also aware that Kate Middleton has a bit of a different skin complexion to me. She's a little bit darker, so perhaps it goes better with her tone of skin. The LK Bennett shoe also has stitching that is more obvious than the very discreet stitching that Jimmy shoe has, which I actually prefer Jimmy shoe stitching. I'd rather pay a couple of $100 extra just to have it more discreet, because it just looks more elegant in my opinion. This can look a little bit, not high street, but not as high end as this. Now, what about the comfort and feel of the shoe? Well, I actually think that the LK Bennett ones are more comfortable than the Jimmy shoe. The Jimmy shoe are a little bit narrower, versus LK Bennett feels more true to size and more comfortable for me to wear. I bought these in size 40, which is my true size. So yes, these ones are a bit small on my foot versus these. Fits me perfectly well. So next up, we have something that is not really identical to what she wore, but it's the same item, and I'm talking about the coat. So Kate wore this exact coat in the color pink. Yet again, it was really hard to find, but actually, I'm quite pleased with the camel version that I got instead. So this is by a brand called Hobbs, which is a brand that I personally love a lot. Again, a British brand. We do have a running theme in this video today. I was quite surprised when I received this coat, because I was like, wow, this feels like something Max Mara would do. It feels really high-end when I touch it. It doesn't feel like a high street coat. And Hobbs is a bit of a high street brand in the UK. So that's why I was a little bit perplexed to what was going on. Now then, when I had a look at the price tag, which was about 600 British pounds, I understood, like, okay, aha, now we are talking Max Mara prices, because that is quite pricey for a coat. Don't you agree, ladies? Leave me a comment below what you think is a reasonable amount to spend on a coat that you wear year after year. In my personal assessment, what would make a coat look high street is oftentimes that it doesn't follow the body structure really well, it doesn't have good tailoring. Here, I feel like it fits me really well from the get-go. I also appreciate the fact that it doesn't wrinkle anywhere. You will see that on many fast fashion coats, like Zara as an example. The coat might be a bit wrinkly, might, I don't know, poke out a little bit there in the fabric, because it's not perfectly aligned and it doesn't follow the body line or lays nicely. What I really appreciate with this coat is the feel of it. Because one thing that I really can't stand with fast fashion coats is the feel. When you touch it like this, it feels synthetic. It doesn't feel luxurious. But when you touch a coat that is a little bit more mid-range or premium, it doesn't have the same synthetic feeling. Like this Hobbs coat feels very luxurious. It almost makes me feel like, oh, is this real cashmere? Is this real wool? What is this? It feels really expensive. One detail that I do appreciate with this coat is the fact that it's single-breasted. You have an option to have double-breasted coats. I am not a big fan of them. Partly because I'm an hourglass body shape, and because of the curvy nature of an hourglass body shape, double-breasted tend not to be as comfortable or flattering looking, but single-breasted are my first choice. I like to have my coats open. Not always, but I do like to have that option. So if I wear my single-breasted coat open like this, I know that it's not really gonna lose its shape. It's gonna remain pretty much the same looking as if it's buttoned. And that's what I like about it, that it stays very feminine, very figure-fitted, and doesn't lose its shape. Here we have a look of a brand that I personally shop from a lot, Self Portrait. They do many beautiful, classy and elegant type of clothes. And this is actually a dress that Kate has worn in different variations. And this variation in white, she wore to the Platinum Jubilee, which was a total hit. Now the price of this garment is around $500 US, which I understand, it's quite a lot of money. But on today's list, it's somewhere in the middle. I really like this type of look because I know where the inspiration comes from, and that is from Dior. Christian Dior made the blazer with the belt with the skirt very popular. And then you have many brands who have replicated that look, Self Portrait included, who made it more affordable versus the original. I really do like this combination though. I think adding a belt to a blazer creates a beautiful feminine silhouette, and I think having a nice A-line skirt underneath is a fantastic idea. The only thing that I don't like about this look is actually the lace detail of this pleated skirt. I don't know whether I would have preferred a completely pleated skirt or maybe some other variation, but I just don't like the pleats in combination with the lace. I love this look. This is my favorite look of today's list. Yes, we saw a variation, identical variation of this outfit from Self Portrait in the clip before, but truly ladies, for me, this is an absolute upgrade from what we saw earlier. The reason for that is fairly simple. I really like the fabric that this outfit is made of. The previous version is made out of tweed or kind of Zara looking tweed, in my opinion. That's why I don't like it as much. And then you had the lace detail and the pleats, and it kind of all looked like, you know what, if that dress came from Zara, we wouldn't be surprised it was from Zara. However, this one looks so much more high quality. It almost looks vintage without being boring old school vintage, more like, ah, it's made out of high quality fabrics. It has a perfect structure to it. It looks very tailored, perfectly figure fitted, has a beautiful feminine and elegant silhouette, and everything just looks very well made. And that's why I like it. But I also do like the fact that you have this embroidery here. It kind of removes a little bit of the formality of everything because it adds a form of romance to the outfit. I do like the fact that it has a leather belt, a contrasting belt. However, in April 2022, when Kay Middleton wore this exact outfit, she actually had a different belt. And I'm not 100% sure whether she wore a variation of this dress that had a different belt, or if her stylist changed out this belt to a different belt. I actually do prefer her variation. I think it's a little bit nicer with a monochrome type of belt where it just blends into the whole outfit. But then again, I also do like this contrasting color because it adds a little bit of flavor to an overall kind of beige and plain looking outfit. Although in my opinion, it's not plain looking at all. In fact, I think it's the perfect conservative outfit. Very feminine and elegant. Let's talk jewelry. And I'm actually going to talk about custom jewelry, which in a way I'm personally a little bit surprised about, because when I saw that Kate Middleton doesn't always wear high-end jewelry, really expensive jewels that she probably inherited through the royal collection, she actually wears a lot of simpler jewelry, like high street jewelry. Like here we have a pair of earrings. Surely they're in the mid-range brand section. We're talking about $170. But these earrings are made with a genuine ruby gemstone. And then around it, you have some crystals that kind of add a little bit of sparkle to the whole mix. When I saw these earrings, I said, oh yes, these beautiful burgundy earrings look fantastic on Kate Middleton, but they're not gonna look good on me because we have a completely different complexion. And here we have a pair of Monica Vinader onyx green earrings. Not my personal favorite, but a big favorite of Kate Middleton. She wore them a lot in 2016, and generally speaking, we have seen her wearing them from time to time. They don't suit me at all. The complexion and these green gold does not work on myself. But of course, with Kate Middleton's brown hair and slightly darker skin tone, complexion works of course so much better than on me. But I must tell you that I think the shape of these earrings are incredibly elegant. And had this just been in a different color, I guess I would have loved it as much as Kate loves them. Now in my next video, I'm gonna teach you more about how you can become more elegant and always look expensive to elevate your wardrobe so that you look as gorgeous as Kate Middleton, if not more. I will see you in that video.